The National Academies of Sciences, Engineering, and Medicine has concluded in a report that the most probable cause of a series of mysterious afflictions that affected American personnel abroad was radio frequency energy. Viewers may note that for several years, U.S. spies and diplomats have experienced what seemed like a directed attack. This came to be known as Havana Syndrome, since it was first detected in diplomats operating in the Cuban capital, Havana. These people suffered from dizziness, fatigue, headaches, and loss of hearing, as well as memory. The condition was so bad for some that they were forced into permanent retirement. The inference by a committee of 19 experts in medicine and other fields cited directed pulsed radio frequency energy as the most plausible mechanism to explain the illness. The report didn't rule out other possible causes, and that secondary factors may have contributed to symptoms. This is, till now, the clearest explanation of the illness that struck the U.S. government employees in Havana in 2016, and then in China and several other countries, including Australia. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Russia is suspected to have injured American personnel using directed microwave weapons. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. These strange symptoms experienced by dozens of U.S. officials, and in some cases their families, has been a mystery. There was speculation that these were caused by a secret high-tech weapon and a foreign hand was involved. For example, last year, two CIA agents assessed that they were attacked with a sophisticated microwave weapon while visiting Australia. The CIA officials reported hearing ringing in their ears and feeling nauseous and dizzy, symptoms similar to Havana Syndrome. According to a report in America's GQ magazine, mobile phone data revealed agents from Moscow's Federal Security Service, FSB, were in the vicinity of their hotel room at the time the visitors fell ill. GQ reported, "While in their hotel rooms in Australia, both of the Americans felt it, the strange sound, the pressure in their heads, the ringing in their ears." The circumstantial evidence pointed to a global campaign as part of which Russia seems to be targeting U.S. officials. Interestingly, in several cases, the officers were thought to be traveling to discuss countering Russian covert operations with foreign intelligence agencies. The report indicates that the incidents were the result of a malicious attack. It attributes the illnesses to directed and pulsed rather than continuous energy. This basically implied that the victims were targeted purposefully and that this was not the result of more common sources of microwave energy, such as a mobile phone. The report does not point a finger at a specific country, but it mentions significant research in Russia/USSR on pulsed radio frequency technology, as well as the exposure of military personnel in Eurasian communist countries to microwave radiation. A microwave is a form of electromagnetic radiation with wavelengths ranging from about 1 meter to 1 millimeter, with frequencies between 300 megahertz, 1 meter, and 300 gigahertz, 1 millimeter. It's to be noted that microwaves travel by line of sight. Unlike lower frequency radio waves, they do not diffract. Dr. David Relman, a Stanford University professor who led the committee, wrote in a preface to the report that the committee was not in a position to assess specific scenarios involving malevolent actors. Yet, he said, the mere consideration of such a scenario raises grave concerns about a world with disinhibited malevolent actors and new tools for causing harm to others. The panel stated its findings were hampered by the government's slow and uneven response to the incidents, in which patients were evaluated by various methods and clinicians at different points in their illnesses. Because the information made available on patients from China was too sparse and fragmentary to be able to draw any substantive conclusion about their cases, the report focuses on events surrounding the U.S. Embassy in Havana. There is historical precedence that indicates that Russia may be responsible for these attacks. The Soviet Union inundated the American Embassy in Moscow with microwaves in the 1970s and 80s. The low power frequencies recorded in the embassy was named Moscow Signal by United States intelligence officials. The Moscow Signal was a reported microwave transmission varying between 2.5 and 4 GHz directed at the Embassy of the United States Moscow from 1953 to 1976, resulting in an international incident. The U.S. government eventually determined it was probably an attempt at espionage and that there was no significant health effects on embassy staff. The microwave transmissions were only 5 microwatts per square centimeter, which is well below the power level of microwave ovens and well below what would be needed to heat anything. However, the frequencies were 100 times more powerful than the Soviet Union's maximum exposure standards, and this caused concern among U.S. officials. In a 2014 document, the National Security Agency discussed a microwave weapon used by a hostile country, which people having knowledge have revealed to be Russia. These attacks are hard to detect, being invisible, making them totally different from traditional attacks like gunfire. Also, since they've resulted in varying level of symptoms, they're hard to quantify in terms of severity. It's to be noted here that different people may exhibit different levels of symptoms, even when the exposure is the same. So it's possible that the method will see continued use, even though it's been exposed to an extent. The report by the National Academies also contains a warning about the possibility of future episodes and the U.S. government's ability to detect them or to mount a response. Another aspect is that the scope of the operation seems to be very elaborate as it pans across multiple nations. Russia seems to be employing these tactics as part of a larger game plan. There were some reports that the attacks in China may have been perpetrated by the Chinese communist regime. This had the potential to sour the relationship between the US and China further. The idea seems to be to create confusion and destabilize the American diplomatic outreach. A lot of research is likely to have gone into the weapon. Another interesting point is that the Russian operative has been able to move these weapons to other countries and operate them without getting caught by the agencies of the host nations. It remains to be seen how the U.S. government counters this suspected Russian onslaught. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.